Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to introduce this network USB print server. It has lots of functions, connection types. It can share a printer, scanner, USB disk, USB camera, keyboards, and USB dongles. So today we're going to work on the two scenarios. First one is we plug this printer into the print server, and then we can access the same printer from multiple computers. Second scenario is, if I have a software that requires a physical dongle. Dongle is look like a USB drive, but it's not a USB drive. So you have plug into your computer to make a software work. Really expensive software does this. So you have three laptops, then I need to buy three copies of software, have three dongles when I share the printer. So instead of sharing a printer, dongle is more expensive. How about we just have one dongle, then we share on the multiple printers. Of course, if this works, you can put both the USB dongle and the printer on the print server. Then now only thing you need is multiple laptops. All of them can drive those. For the LK100EW series, you can notice that there's only one USB port and that there's two Cat5 ports, and they give you a Cat5 cable. I don't know if you guys still using desktop or not. I use a laptop, but the Cat5 have no use for me. Here's the power cable and the power converter. Here's my network not capable L1800. Before this network server, I just run the USB from each computer I have. And notice only the system light is lighted. Now we go to our computer and we're going to see a network is called USB server underscore setup. We connect. You're going to see a link said open browser and connect, but actually there's a pop-up window open for you already. Select the network and then input the Wi-Fi password. And wait a while, and after it complete, it's going to kick you off the network. And notice way back to the regular network that we were using for office. This Harris network is 5G network. Currently, this product only supports 2.4G Wi-Fi network, not 5G. They are actually working on a future version that supports both dual brand, including 5G. Now we're back to our normal network. We type in xiiozet.local. Password is admin. This is old, like a control panel for your box. Under virtual USB setting, and you can see your basic setting, and also you can see your device list. This will show you which device is plugged into your USB connection. For regular folks that you're not working on DTF, you just want to share a printer, you can go to the IPP setting. Now let me show you another web page. Instead of .local, now you go to .net and you do a /download. You can find a printer quick installation tool for Windows. So you can install this printer using the IP address or host names. This will be the most common way to set up your printer. However, if you set up that way, you're going to notice you cannot run adjustment program. Say this USB port only go to 36, and the way you set up the IPP and the port is 9000. The Epson program cannot see beyond 36. So regular folks do the IPP, but for the DTF folks, you go download the virtual USB connect tool from that download page I showed you earlier. If you use the Chrome browser, you have to tell Chrome, I'm going to keep it. Run it. It will ask you to select a folder you want to install it. And if you want to run it after installation, of course. For some reason, it always shows you the print box cannot be found. Just click refresh. And here's our L1800 mounted on our computer. Just be sure, because we installed the Epson driver, So that's why it just like you plug in a USB. If you never install the Epson driver on your computer, you'll need to install the driver. This is equivalent to we physically plug in the printer through a USB port. So the Epson going to mount it below 36. Now we run the adjustment program. You can see the Epson mounted on port 11. Okay, so it's ready to go. Now we're going to work on the second scenario, which is we put a USB dongle of the RIP software on the print server, and we connect from multiple computers. Just to make it clear, in this virtual USB mode, each connected USB device, like a dongle or printer, can only be accessed by one computer at a time. So this is an exclusive connection. However, the device can still be shared sequentially among different computers, so you don't have to carry around. For the printers, I showed you earlier, instead of sharing it as a USB device, you can mount the printer with IP or hostname. This way, it doesn't have the occupying issue with a virtual USB. Multiple computers can send in their jobs at the same time, and the printer will handle them in a queue. So back to our dongle. This dongle is $600. So we place this one dongle into the print server. And back to USB 2, refresh, and click connect. Okay. Now it's similar to plugging the dongle into our computer. So let's fire up the RIP software and see if the RIP software can detect the dongle. And you can see the RIP software can load without any problem. And this dongle is wirelessly 30 feet away from the computer, no cord, wireless. Okay, we're going to walk to the second computer. This always happens. I fire up a DTF. Oh, there's no dongle. I forgot to take the dongle here. And on this computer, only thing I need to do is go to the download page and download the virtual USB 2 and install it. Again, the same thing. It says the print box not found. Refresh. And says our dongle is occupied. And we click disconnect and ask you, do you want to disconnect the dongle from the first computer? And click yes. And you can see theoretically only one computer can use the dongle. But you can put the software on multiple computers. And we can load it up and print. So now you can just put that little print server anywhere in office. And then you don't have to worry about losing it, and you don't need to carry it around all the time. Now we walk back to the first printer, and remember, we unplugged the dongle from this one. What the interesting is, if physically unplug a dongle, the program will shut down automatically. But in this case, the program's still up. Let's say if we can print. There's no problem printing from the first one. So we got one dongle that can make two computers working at the same time. I don't know how it happens, but it happens. This small profile network server is going to save lots of time and headache. Again, the link to the product is in my description if you think it's useful for you. And also please comment, say you like it. So maybe next time they're going to ask me to test their L300, which I really want to get. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!